To determine the scope of the building or data lake, we have to first clarify the need and want of having a data lake solution. So the need here is empowering management with data-driven decision-making capabilities. And the want here is the ability to execute self-service analytics. So before going into the scope, and after we have the need and want, I will like to say a few things about the data lake, because that would help us in the process. So the term data lake was first described by CTO of Pentaho, James Dixon. So in his words, what he said was, if we consider data mart as a store of bottled water, cleansed and packaged and structured for easy consumption, the data lake is basically a large body of water in a more natural state. The content of the data lake stream in from a source to fill the lake, and various users of the lake can come to examine, dive in, or take samples. So the critical point here is, one, the data is in its original form and format, that is the raw format of the natural data. Number two is the data is used by various users, that is accessed and accessible by a large user community. So once we align the company business strategy, executive sponsorship, and broad buy-in that has been accomplished, and it's a must for it, three key scopes emerge for building a successful data lake solution. So what are they? Number one is the right platform. So by right platform, we mean whether we need an on-premise solution or rent a public cloud, or an enterprise as a service hybrid solution. And number two is the right data. The goal here is to save as much data as possible. We must avoid data silos. And lastly, the transparency in data governance that is well documented process to access the data. And the final point is in the scope is three, that is the right interface. So the right interface involves two things, that is providing the data at the right level of expertise and ensuring the users are able to find the right data.